Hello students, welcome back to the class. So the last class we have discussed about extremist phase of movement. In this class we will discuss about Gandhian phase of freedom movement. In the last class we have discussed that 1905 to 1919, that period is called extremist period, in which we have discussed about the what is meant by extremist, introduction. Okay, the person who wanted to achieve the independence by forceful method or by violent method, so they were called as extremist. We have discussed about what are the roles, okay, roles of the extremist we have discussed. In these classes we are going for a new topic next to extremist, that is Gandhian phase. In this class we have discussed about the Gandhian phase of freedom movement. So already we have discussed three phase of freedom movement: moderate period, extremist period, Gandhian era. So moderate period, first one, extremist period, which is completed. Now we are going for a Gandhian era. Now in Gandhian phase, this freedom movement is called Gandhian phase. The freedom movement which was started from 1920 to 1947. This is the longest phase among all the freedom movement of our country. Moderate period, if you see, it is just for 20 years. Extremist period, if you see, 15 years. In Gandhian era, if you see, this is mainly for 27 years. Okay, this is one of the longest. This is the longest freedom phase. Okay, now when we are talking about moderate period, it is moderate phase is started from 1885 to 1905. Extremist phase started from 1905 to 1919. But Gandhian phase is started from 1920 to 1947. So that period was mainly started by Mahatma Gandhi. During this period, Mahatma Gandhi have launched one of the major movement, three major movement, and that's why this period is called as Gandhian era. And we got independence in Gandhian era. Moderate, extremist, they played very important role, and their role is also very important. And in Gandhian phase, we got independence, and that's why this period is called as Gandhian phase of independence. Because this period was led by Mahatma Gandhi. From 1920 to 1947, he led a movement, and that's why this period is called Gandhian phase of freedom movement. Now this is the final stage. This is the last stage. Why? Because in the Gandhian phase, when the Mahatma Gandhi have led a movement, we will get independence. After, when the Mahatma Gandhi will lead the movement, we will get independence, and that's why this is very important movement. In this movement, if you see, Mahatma Gandhi played a very crucial role, very important role he played to achieve the freedom of our country. So Mahatma Gandhi have launched three major movement to achieve the freedom of the country, and that's why he played a very crucial role. After coming from South Africa from 1915, Mahatma Gandhi have understand the conditions, and then he started playing a very important role for our country. And very soon he was appointed as a leader of Indian Congress Party, and from 1920 to 1947 he played a very important role, and he played a very crucial role. He adopted a very unique technique which is called Satyagraha and confidence. Satya and Agraha is a combination of two words. One is called truth. Agraha means holding fast. To achieve any independence, always Mahatma Gandhi believed that we should follow the non-violent method. Okay, same principle, moderate also adopted. Okay, Mahatma Gandhi also adopted the same principle. If you wanted to achieve independence, you should be non-violent, and you should follow the two important path. You should have confidence, and you should follow the path of Satyagraha. Okay, Satya, Agraha is a combination of two words. Satya in the sense truth. Always you should be in the way of truth, and you should be holding fast to achieve the independence. So that is called as Satyagraha. Now if you see that Mahatma Gandhi have started three major movement. Okay, so first major movement he was started non-cooperation movement. Second major movement he started civil disobedience movement. And third major movement he started Quit India movement. So if you see, the first major movement was non-cooperation movement, which was started from 1920 to 1922. So this non-cooperation movement was started from 20 to 22. It was started by Mahatma Gandhi because of reason like Jallianwala Bagh massacre. During that time, what happened in India, in Punjab, an incident took place. In that incident, what happened? 4,000 people have lost their 400 people, 400 to 500 people have lost their life in Amritsar in Punjab. okay, by British fire, by the British's firing. So 400 to 500 people have lost, and this incident completely shocked the nation, which is called as Jallianwala Bagh massacre. And that is the reason that Mahatma Gandhi have started a non-cooperation movement. Next important thing is Rowlatt Act. During that time in non-cooperation, Britishers has passed one act which is called Rowlatt Act. What is called Rowlatt Act? This act was passed in 1919. Children, according to this act, Britishers is giving and empowering the police forces that they can able to arrest any person without any reason also, without having any proof also, without having anything, they can able to arrest any person by this act. This act was passed by Sir Rowlatt, and that's why this act was called Rowlatt Act. So these two things, which is quite unfavorable for the Indian people. So one is Jallianwala Bagh massacre, because in this incident in Punjab, without any reason, the Britishers have opened a fire upon the people and killing 400 people. Without any reason, they have opened the fire, and in which 400 people have lost their life. This is one point. Okay, and Rowlatt Act. Rowlatt Act was first to Jallianwala Bagh massacre. In this act, Britishers have given more power to the police force that they can able to arrest any person and they can send them to jail. So this is a part. So after starting this act by the Britishers, Mahatma Gandhi decided to form the non-cooperation movement. So Mahatma Gandhi clearly warned all the people that when this movement is going on, always you have to follow a peaceful method. Okay, by achieving a peaceful method only we have to reach the goal. He have stated confident as well as satyagraha, truth and non-violence every time. Other two movements were also started by Mahatma Gandhi, which is called Civil Disobedience Movement and Quit India Movement. Civil Disobedience Movement, which was started in 1930. During 1930, Mahatma Gandhi have started one more major movement, Civil Disobedience Movement. This movement is also called as Salt Satyagraha. Why this movement was mainly started? Because Britishers have imposed some taxes upon salt. Okay, and that's why this movement was started. So this Civil Disobedience Movement, which is called Salt Satyagraha. Okay, in this movement, Mahatma Gandhi have taken place and he prepared a salt. During this time, Britishers has made a tax that law. They have made a law that nobody should buy salt. Okay, nobody should buy salt from the sea, and nobody should manufacture a salt from the sea. They should buy from only British. So Mahatma Gandhi have decided to break the salt. He went to coastal areas from Dandi, and there he manufactured a salt. And there Mahatma Gandhi was arrested, because he broke any salt. So during that time already Britishers has warned that nobody should go to any areas, coastal areas, and should prepare a salt. If they wanted to buy any salt, they should buy from only British. But during that time Mahatma Gandhi have started this movement. By this he went to the coastal areas from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi, and then he broke the salt law. Third major movement which was started in Mahatma Gandhi, which is called Quit India Movement, which was started in 1940. In this movement, Mahatma Gandhi has asked the Britishers to leave India or quit India. This was started in August. Okay, during August, this movement was started. On 8th August 1942, the Quit India Movement was started. So during this Quit India Movement, Mahatma Gandhi has given a slogan, do or die. Okay, so by these three movements, Mahatma Gandhi was able to achieve independence. So that's why these three movements were the part of Gandhian base. Okay, and because of these three movements, we got independence. Now we'll go forward. Mahatma Gandhi was greatly supported by many people. First one, Lala Lajpat Rai. Okay, he is a important leader of extremist. So Lala Lajpat Rai during that time have greatly supported, and he played a very important role. He participated in the movement which was started by Mahatma Gandhi, non-cooperation movement first. So whatever the non-cooperation movement which was started by Mahatma Gandhiji, Lala Lajpat Rai participated in that movement. And he was also supported by Indian National Congress. During that time, all the Congress party have supported Mahatma Gandhi, and they selected Mahatma Gandhi as a main leader of Indian National Congress. So this is about the support. So when we are talking about the support, he got mainly support from Indian National Congress and Lala Lajpat Rai. Now, many Congress leaders have taken some positive and negative program. Okay, they have spread the movement which was started by Mahatma Gandhi. So many Congress leaders have started many type of movements, positive programs they have started, and they greatly supported Mahatma Gandhi. Now, if you are talking about some positive movements, what are the positive movements? Using Swadeshi goods means using the Indian made goods. We should not use any other goods which are made. Foreign goods should not be used, only the goods which was manufactured in India, that goods are called as Swadeshi goods, that goods only we should make. 20 lakh sarkars were distributed to unemployment people. So Mahatma Gandhi during that time, there were no major industries. So sarkars they have distributed to all the people, okay, so that they can able to self-reliant regarding clothing. So 20 lakhs of charkas were distributed to unemployment people, raising 1 crore of the people to increase the other activities. So there what happened, they used to collect the funds from all over the country, and from these funds what they used to do, they used to utilize that fund for the development activities. So they have raised the fund 1 crore of rupees. So after raising that fund, they have utilized that fund for the development activities. So this is one of the positive programs. Now national education plan, Mahatma Gandhi, many Congress leaders have started some positive plan, which is one called National Education Plan, is also one of the positive plan. And Congress legislative body, so Mahatma during this time Mahatma Gandhi decided to replace the British Parliament with the Congress legislative parliament. So these are the positive steps. So once again, Swadeshi goods, okay, distribution of charkas, raising of funds up to 1 crore of rupees by collecting the funds and utilizing for the development activity, giving importance for education, and Congress local legislative bodies will be replaced with British legislative body. During that time, Mahatma leaders have gave up the titles. So when Mahatma Gandhi have asked the leaders to give their titles, gave up the titles, many leaders they came forward and they supported the movement of Mahatma Gandhi and they have given up the titles. So now if we are talking about the titles, Mahatma Gandhi have got a title which is called Kesare Hind. Mahatma Gandhi have provided lot of services. Even during the South Africa also, he provided lot of services to the people of South Africa. When he came to India, he provided many services, like some important Champaran activity and Kheda. So Kheda and Champaran activities, he resolved the problems. Kheda and Champaran, where the people are facing a problem, farmers, so he solved the problem there. So because of that, Britishers has given him a title, Kesare Hind, and the title was rejected by Mahatma Gandhi. He have denounced his title, Kesare Hind. So in the same time, Rabindranath Tagore also got a title which is called Knighthood Award. So Knighthood is a title which is given to Rabindranath Tagore, okay, for his service, okay. So Rabindranath Tagore have written some literature book, okay, and due to which he got a title which is called Knighthood. Knighthood is the highest award which is given to any citizen by the England, okay, that is one point. And one more activity is after the when the Mahatma Gandhi has started a movement, during that time in the non-cooperation movement, Mahatma Gandhi has made 5 days fast to withdraw the movement, because he already said that movement should be in the non-violent activity. So when he saw the movement is going to the violent activity at last, Mahatma Gandhi planned to withdraw the movement. Okay, he made a 5-day plan to withdraw the movement. So here we have understand what are the various movement which was started by Mahatma Gandhi and how he can able to achieve the independence. So here we have discussed that this period was started by Mahatma Gandhi, and that's why this period is called Gandhian phase, and this period was started from 1920 to 1947. Okay, so this is also called as final stage, in which Mahatma Gandhi played a very crucial role. Mahatma Gandhi have adopted some unique techniques like satyagraha and confidence, which are very important to achieve the goal. Mahatma Gandhi have started 3 major movement: non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience movement, Quit India movement. So in this movement, first one, non-cooperation movement, which was started from 1920, this was mainly started because during that time the Britishers have made an Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So they have shoot without any reason, they have shooted an innocent people in Punjab, killing 4,000 to 5,000 people, have lost their life. And the All Out Act, which was started by Britishers, this act is empowering the British forces and police forces, they can able to arrest a person without having any reason. So because of these two acts, Mahatma Gandhi has went for non-cooperation movement in 1920 to 1922, and he got lot of support. Whenever he started all this movement, he got support. First, Mahatma Gandhi was supported by Lala Lajpat Rai and Indian Congress people, and many Congress people they have taken some positive and negative and positive programs, and they spread the movement of Mahatma Gandhi. First, if we are talking about some positive movements, in which we can find Swadeshi goods. First, they have to use the Swadeshi goods only. In this movement, they have planned to distribute the 20 lakhs of charkha to the unemployment peoples, and they have raised a fund of 1 crore of rupees, and they planned to develop the national education plan, and Mahatma Gandhi decided to replace the Congress legislative body with British's legislative body. In this movement, many leaders have given up the title. In the Mahatma Gandhi made a call, many leaders have given up the title. Okay, Vinoba Bhave, like that, various leaders, Rabindranath Tagore, and himself Mahatma Gandhi also have given the title Kesari Hind, which was given by British officers. And Rabindranath Tagore also have refused his title knighthood, which was given by British officers. During that time, Mahatma Gandhi has went for 5 days fasting to withdraw the movement, because when he saw the movement is going in the non-violence activity, when the movement is going towards violence activity, so Mahatma Gandhi has made a plan, 5 days fast to withdraw the movement. So children, here we have discussed, even though by using the movement at last in 1947 we are able to achieve our independence, and the last movement which was started by Mahatma Gandhi, Quit India movement. In this, Mahatma Gandhi have started directly leave India. In this Quit India movement is the last movement. After completing this, we got independence. So 1947, so here we have understand that how these movements are responsible for achieving independence. So Mahatma Gandhi played a very important role, and that's why this period is called as Gandhian phase of freedom struggle or freedom movement. Okay, children, thank you very much. We will meet you in the next class.